for part three of our isometric assignment, what you're supposed to do is to create your own shape and then draw it on isometric paper. For this part, you're going to use up to 8 cubes, and you can basically create any shape you want. So I created this one right here, and I'm going to show you a couple different ways to draw this on paper. When you are creating your own shape, you have the ability to determine what the front, the top, and the side view are. And then whatever you choose for that is going to determine what your shape is going to look like on a piece of paper, on this piece of paper. So as we look at this, if, for example, if I wanted to make this my front view, then this would be basically what it's going to look like on a piece of paper, something like that. So I'm going to see this as my front. The front is going to be pointing in this direction right here. I've got my top, and then my side is coming from over here. I could also make this my top. And if I did that, then this would now be my front. This would be my top, so my hole would be going vertical instead of horizontal. And then this would be my side. So I'm going to actually show you guys both ways for this one. But the thing I want you to know is that when you create your own shape, you have to choose what the front view is. Typically in drafting or engineering or designing, the front view is going to be the view that has the most detail. So when I'm looking at this, I would say that this probably has the most detail. So this is what I'm going to do. But, you know, depending on the type of shape, sometimes it's actually easier to draw it this way. All right. So you guys get to choose what makes the most sense to you and whatever you can accomplish. Both will work. Or whichever way you draw it will work. So I'm going to draw it this way first. So as I'm looking at this, I've got my top right here. One segment, three segments. So that's my top. Now I'm going to work my way down. As I'm working my way down, these are 3 cubes tall, all the, both those lines are. And then I'm going to finish off the bottom. And we're almost done. My last step is to actually draw the hole that's there. So that hole is going to be right in the middle there. And then lastly, as we're looking at this, when I look at this on an angle, there's one edge I still haven't drawn yet. And that's going to be this edge right there. So I still got to show that one on my piece of paper because I can see it right here. So that is actually going to be this edge. Just like that. It almost makes it a little bit harder to see, but that is the correct way to draw this shape right here. Now the other thing I would do is I would actually add some hidden lines on the side, because we know that this is going all the way through. When we look at it on the side, though, we can't actually see that. So if we look at it straight on, we can't tell that there's a hole going through it, even though we know there is. So there is an edge right here below the surface, and then another one right on this bottom part right here where my pencil is. So those are both running horizontal. So those would actually look something like this. When we draw a hidden line, we actually use dashes for that. Still use a straight edge, but there we go. So now we're showing that there is a hole that is going all the way through. If I wanted to make this my top and make this my front and this one my side, I'm going to draw it a little bit differently. Okay, and this is why I said sometimes it's easier to lay something flat. So if you've got a single set of cubes like this where they're all, you know, in one row or whatever you want to call it, sometimes it's easier to draw it this way than that way. It just depends. For my top, I've got basically a square that is 3x3 with a hole in the middle. I'm going to lay out my points for that. So I got that portion done. Now I'm going to work on these lines right here. There's three of them, and they're 1 cube tall as of right now because this is my front view. Now I'm going to finish that part off. Got this hole that is right in the middle, so that's going to be right over here. And then as we're looking at this on an angle, we can also see that I've got this inside edge right here that goes all the way down. So I've got to show that. That's going to go right over here. So that would be another way to draw the same shape. And then if I wanted to go a step further with this, I could add the hidden lines to that. This is going to look a little confusing. But when I look at this straight on from the front view or from the side view, it's basically the same image. I do have a set of edges right on the inside here. So underneath this outer portion, there's an edge on the inside right over there. And then the same thing here on the underside of this edge right here, there's this bottom edge for the hole. So to do that, I'm going to add some hidden lines. I got the front part done, and then it's going to be the same thing over here. We tend to use hidden lines a little bit more when we do multi-view drawing, but just to kind of show you how you would do hidden lines on an isometric, that's what I'm really doing right here. Okay, and so all these are doing is showing that this hole is going all the way through. And again, from the front view here, we've got these edges, and then the same thing when I go to the side view, you've got two more edges that are coming down to make the four corners of the hole. So that would be taking a set of Lincoln cubes, creating your own shape, and then creating the isometric from it. Take care. And I spoke too soon. If you were looking at this, I don't know if you caught this or not, but I did not add my hidden lines for the top over here. I still need to add those. Because just like on the side here, there is going to be another set of hidden lines that would be in the top. So if my shape is this position right here, I've got an edge underneath here, and I've got another edge that is underneath here. That would be this one and that one. So I do need to draw those as well. There we go. So that would be my completed drawing for the shape.